Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning to you too.
Happy Friday.
It's our last Friday of the school year.
It is. I can't believe that. No. This year has gone by too quickly. But here we are at the end of the school year, coming to the close. So we have a lot of activities today. We have the talent show this afternoon from 12 to 2. Excited to see the acts. I haven't been privy to any of them, so I'm looking forward to seeing everyone perform. And today begins our GV Honors Week. And so today we will feature kindergarten and first graders. But before we get to that, I ask that you join me in the Pledge of Allegiance and the moment of silence. So if you would, please join me. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And we're back. Thank you for joining us in the pledge and the moment of silence. Appreciate that. Thank you to all of those who might have been in the hallway who stopped and met expectations with that. And we'll proceed with our GV Honors Day.
But first,
with
we kindergarten and
first
out.
Grade. What are we eating?
Yeah, no, that's the thing. We got to figure out first things first. All about the food. Today we have choice of one: turkey tetrazzini or fish nuggets with hush puppies and a chef salad meal. Choice of two: vegetables, green lima beans, roasted baby red potatoes, romaine garden salad, excuse me, and choice of one fruit: fresh and canned fruit or cinnamon apples. All right, now we can get down to business.
Feel a little choked up about that garden
salad.
Yes,
I know. We love my salads.
All righty then.
Okay, I think we're ready for some big awards.
We are ready. Let's proceed.
All right, we're going to start off with art awards. And these awards, these are students that have had their artwork displayed throughout the city somewhere. And we have some first graders to be recognized. And these students had their artwork displayed at the Hoover Library exhibit. So maybe
very talented people,
that.
Good artists.
Yes, Sophie Temple, Jordan Stevens, Amber Ford, and Amari Hobson. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
And at Central Office, we had these students display their work. I love going to Central Office and seeing all the artwork.
It's an art gallery.
It makes you proud.
Our building is an art gallery.
It
Everybody's talents are displayed. Great job, Gators.
Okay, these are the Central Office exhibit people. Lacey LaBelle, Lenton Crittenden, Kimberly Blair, Ella Walker, Jeremy Cook, Charlene Gamow, Parker Crossman, and Jolie Holmes.
Congratulations, Gators.
Very nice.
Great job. And thank you to Ms. Morgan for doing such a great job, for honing those talents and getting those skills and making our building an art gallery. We've had so many comments throughout the year about the art and how it just helps to liven up the building. So
I appreciate it. And I hate it being taken down this time of the year. It makes
Well, it lets us know that it's coming to a close. We may not believe it, but when we see the art coming down, that's a symbol of the year coming to an end. But certainly, the one thing that won't come to an end is our Gators' contributions to community service. Today, we want to acknowledge a kindergartner and first grader who have met those expectations and have done their part to make Green Valley and their surrounding area, Hoover City, a better place. I want to acknowledge Jack Watts from Russ's class. Congratulations, Mr. Watts. And first grader Jacob Hoggle from Ms. Smith's class. Congratulations, very proud of you. Keep that community service going, very proud of you. We have our representatives for the Finley Award. These are the persons who were honored for outstanding character. And our Gators are from kindergarten, Blake McClellan from Ms. Hardy's class. Congratulations, Blake. And our first graders are Gage Taylor from Ms. Smith's class. Congratulations. Appreciate your contribution, appreciate your being a role model and setting the example of the expectations here in the building, but also just displaying good character when and when people aren't watching. When people are and when they aren't watching. Really appreciate that. Next we have...
your fave.
It's near and dear to my heart.
Don't you get choked up now.
I might. I might need a moment. Okay, I'm good. You were here every day this school year.
I hope they were here today. I didn't check it.
Yeah, maybe absent. We're trying to win it. Up until the day, you've been here every day. You have not missed a day, no matter the weather, no matter your health. You may have been sick, not feeling at your best, but you were here.
They weren't late either.
Not even late. No tardies, no check-ins, no check-outs. You were here. So, with that being said,
we have only one person.
Only one person, but no.
It's hard to do.
That Gator. This is an awesome task. It's an awesome task. So, to Aiden Coleman, my congratulations to you. You have perfect attendance. Great job. Keep up the wonderful work. And I'm sure we'll see you every day next year.
Thank you.
That's all we have for this morning. I hope you enjoyed our first day of GV Honors Week, honoring kindergarten and first graders. Keep the wondrous words and the wondrous work coming. We don't have any wondrous words. Magnificent. That'll be our wondrous word for today.
Right.
Because all of these honorees have done a magnificent job this school year.
We're going to be honoring second and third grade on Monday.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. So stay tuned.
So, wonder who those persons will be.
Is
it you or you? We'll find out Monday. Have a great Gator Day, Gators. S3R.